Lakini sasa wale viongozi wenye muna elect, those are MCA, kwanza MCA, watu hawajui kwamba MCA kitambo barabara ipite kwako, kuna watu kadhaa wanafaa kuwe compensated. That is budgeted corruption. MCA anapata kati yake 10%. Ndiyo, ndiyo aseme, hey, barabara sasa ipite hapa. These people are, bwana, well, let me not talk too much, but thank you so much for giving me this chance.
Swali ya mwisho, who CS wa barabara, Murkomen, unamwona aje, afutwe kazi ama anaweza?
Mkubwa, you are, unauliza, this guy does not ajui anything about, ata ajui kushika futi. Si alikuja kuwa sae tunamuonyesha futi, atipima futi. Ajui ata futi tano ni kusema nini. He doesn't know what are inches. He doesn't know what are millimeters. He doesn't know. Ajui kabisa. Ata ukimuambia, tunaeka hii embankment. Ana embankment ndio nini? Na meno mingi imefunguka kwenda mbele. That he knows nothing at all. See, but that guy, ajui anything? He doesn't. Huyo jamaa anafaa yake kwa ministry. Kama kuna ministry ya mapasta, haiko huko basi. Huyo jamaa kuna kitu anajua kwa site, nothing at all. Watu wenye wanamdanganya, sasa wenye wanakula vizuri ni hao wakina Kenha. Wao akera, wao maengineers, wao wazee, wao wenye wajui anything. Those are the people who are lying to him. But the guy akikuja kwa ground, he knows totally nothing at all. Hata ajui, yani, wacha hata basi, wacha tuanze the basic one. What is a meter? He doesn't know. Hata ujama, sidani hata alienda iskuru gani yu. That guy ni ngombe. Uyo ni ngombe buwana. Mume, nyinyi buwana, uyo jama hata izitolewa hapo, juu anakula poa. Kama mjui, the Ministry of Roads and Transport. Hapo ndiyo pesa hiko buwana. Pesa ni mingi. Uyo jama, akikaa tu hivi kidogo, anasema, niekewe 30 million. Anatoka hapo, amechukua, kwanza, kuna kadem fulani, kalingia Kenya. Very recently too. Keupe hivi kazuri. Ako tunasikia ni kamkubwa. Kanaingia tu hivi. Sasa unadhani mkubwa ni nani? Hawa jamaa ni rungu tu inatembezwa hapo ile sereni na pipe. Hiyo ndio anajua sana. Pipe. Hiyo upande wa pipe, kutembeza pipe. Yeye anajua amekula ma engineers wote. Amemaliza ma engineers wa Rembo wote. Wote karibu anamaliza wakiingia tu kwa ministry huko, wakishaingia kwa hiyo office. I'm telling you, these people are very stupid, bwana. These people are... Mimi hata nipate girlfriend yangu wanaingia Kera, ama Kena, ama sister yangu. Na wambia watoki ukafutani ya rendafte kitu ngini ya kufanya. These people should pack and go home. The CS is nothing compared to anything else. These people are thieves, all of them. Uyo jamaa unauliza atia kaya ama endele. He knows nothing. He should go home. Ana hii barabara hakuna kitu mtaipiji kuja kupata. Hii mabarabara itabomoka karibu yote bwana. So thank you so much for giving me this answer, Afrocentric.
Thank you very much.
2 minutes.
Ahana, before you go,
Asante.
Before you go, there's so many people who had their hands up. If you don't mind, please give the mic to them.
Just 2 minutes. I want to emphasize on what he said because I have some first hand information. Pole six and onsu and reject. Poleni, my apologies. This guy, what he's talking about, the roads, the actually, corruption haiko huko peke yake Nairobi. I am in Kilifi County. It was Kilifi County. Now, you all know Kinge. Kinge, ikikuja tenda, whether it's Kera, whether it's Kura, kwanza watu wenye na iyo tenda ni ya mtu. Sometimes people go bid, companies in enda could bid for that tender, but that tender is already given to somebody. What happens, ni hao officers wanaambia lipa pesa front, up front. Okay? Ni ule mtu haizi kufikia Kingi atalipa hao officers hapo wenye wako. Awapatie 1 million, Kingi anachukua almost 1 million, 1 point whatever, 2 million, 3 million. It depends on how much the tender is costing. Now, uyu mtu mwingine wa hapa chini mwenye hana pesa mingi, atapatia na 500,000, 10,000. You pay maybe 10% or 15% of that tender, total amount of that tender. Now what happens? Mutu atasema na tender ni ya maybe 5 million, maybe ni ya 300,000, maybe ni ya whatever amount it is. Mtu atapatiwa tender hata kama sio ya barabara ya kujenga maybe choo, shule, whatever around there. Mostly barabara. Kuna wengine napatiwa barabara kidogo, eti just kukata mamiti, kupaka hiyo line ya yellow, wanapatiwa. It's the amount that they're going to spend is a fraction of what hiyo pesa yenye wanapatiwa na serikali. Half of that money, mind you, imeingia kwa mfuko ya kinge. Pesa ingine inaingia kwa ule mfuko ya ule mtu mwenye sasa akurilizie pesa ikuje kwa akaunti yako wa kuverify. Wakuambie sijui wanakuja na inspectors ukuwe na site, ukuwe na magari, ukuwe na equipments, ukuwe na engineer hapo. Saa zingine they get to a point where wana fake documents ya engineer, because the engineer has to be on the site wakati kura ama kena is coming to check your site. They have to see the equipment, you have to have a site, you have to have an engineer, and they have to be licensed. Utakuta mtu anariliziwa pesa because hana gari ya kupatrol hizo sites and hana license, anachukua deni on top of that. Now what happens? For the person who gets the small contract, ambaye maybe ni ya kuweka maram peke yake kwa hiyo barabara, sometimes amelipa pesa kwa hiyo mtu wa chini, jamaa ama kingi hata amekula hiyo pesa, simu inatoka Nairobi anaambia hiyo tender it's for X company. Company ambaye haina reference, haijai jenga, ujui wametoa hizo equipment wati maloda-loda, manini, ma zote ziko kwa site. You don't know where they got this money. This person is already out of pocket. Do you think ataacha kingi? No, he will wait for the next contract. And this cycle continues over and over and over again. People yeah. out of kuna watu
to just echo on what you are saying, Anna, sorry to cut you short. I wanted to emphasize on that point ya awa jamaa. Sorry if I'm interjecting. Kuna wajamaa hapa kwa hiyo, kuna wajamaa wako na pending bill ya project zililipwa like 3 years ago, pesa zilishatoka. But what is happening is that hizi pesa zenye zilishatoka za pending bill, pesa zote wakati serikali ilingia, ilisema hizo pesa kwanza zifanye mambo mengine. Hizo pesa ndio zilikuwa zinataka kurudishwa za campaign. So what is MCS and the MPs, what the MPs are doing and the senators and these contractors, kuna contractors sahi karibu kadhaa wamejinyonga kwa sababu ya walichukua loan kutengeneza hizo mabarabara and to supply cabros, kusupply nini. Most of them have committed suicide because kuna wajamao walipeana title deed na wakapeana logbook kwa bank for them to be able to fund the project. People don't know how the projects are funded. First of all, ukisha win tender, unapewa tu 30%. Kuna stages ya kulipwa. Wanakuja wanaangalia umefanya 30%, umefanya kama 60%, umefanya kama 90%, pesa inatoka according to the stage. But for the beginning, lazima uanze na pesa yako kwanza, so that people can see what is happening, topping up, na ndio wakuja wakutop up, wanatuma engineer, anakuja kwa site, anakuja na assess, anasema yes, county engineer, kama ni Kenya engineer, kama ni kura, kama ndio ulipwe as a contractor. So these people, wakisha ngoje sahili umesha fanya kazi, umefikisha kama mahali kama 60%, unasikia at A, pesa yenu imeko kwa pending bill. So unapata kama ulikuwa umepewa barabara tuseme ya 60 ya let's say 30 million or 12 million ulichukua kutoka kwa bank almost 50% of that amount. Hiyo pesa ikishakuja sasa unajua wale wenye uko nao kwa ground maybe hujawalipa ama nini, you have to go to the bank uambie sasa eh, niko na hii LPO ama niko na hii kitu, niko na hii agreement na serikali, mnipatie loan. Sasa mtu unapewa loan, but you have to give that security. Unapeana security ya logbook ama unapeana security ya title deed. So kuna jamaa mwenye najua vest ngawa sahi tulisha muzika, he was a contractor, he had a project in Turkana County, na hii project ilikuwa ya Lodwa Lochanga Matak Highway, he was a supplier. This guy, after kufanya hiyo kazi, alisupply simiti huko, alisupply na chuma. But ilikuwa bill yake ilikuwa almost 25 million, but alikuwa ameshapeleka 15 million tayari, alikuwa yenye ameshatumia kutoka kwa loans zake na kila kitu, kwa sababu Lodo is very far, Turkana is very far, kusupply hizo vitu, kupeleka hizo vitu zote. That guy, vile tunaongea, bank ilikuja ika auction gari yake, ika auction shamba yake, ika auction mpaka bibi akamwacha na watoto wakaanza kuteseka. Mpaka walifungiwa nyumba, walikuwa huko wanaishi huko Dawala. Walikuwa sasa wanatembea tu kwa street, kwa sababu sasa their friends wameshawatroka. Hii jamaa amekopa pesa left, right and center. So the only remaining thing, hata kuna mwingine alienda akiwa uchi. I don't know kama mliona wakati ya 2022, kuna jamaa alienda uchi ya contractor, alikuwa amefanya kazi ya World Bank pia. Akaenda mpaka pale City Hall akiwa uchi, naked. He was a contractor. That guy was not insane. He was a former principal wa shule, yenye sitaki kutaja ni shule gani. But that guy baadaye, baada ya siku mbili tatu, alikuwa disturbed and then akajiua. Kuna contractors kadhaa wengine sahii wako hata kwa hospitali, wako na pressure, wengine wako na heart attack. Do you know pale hizi pesa zinapotelea? Zinapotelea kwa Ministry of Roads and Transport na Infrastructure. Hizi pesa kwa built environment zimepotelea hapo. Kuna contractors wale genuine walifanya kazi yao mzuri kabisa na ni kazi safi. Na ni kazi yenye hata ukiona hata unafurahia, walikuwa watu wa kule faida kidogo. But most of them wamenyang'anywa hiyo pesa na cabinet secretary. Kwa sababu hiyo pesa wanakuja nasema pending bill inatoka, wanakuja wanasema hiyo pesa imekuwa diverted to other purposes. Na hao wajamaa au contractors wanafaa kulipwa. What happens after that? Hii pesa wanakuja wana divert inaenda kwa kitu kingine yenye ni girlfriend wao wamefungua hizo makampuni. Huyo girlfriend anakuja ana pre-qualify, anaweka kampuni pale, anasema sasa mimi ndo nataka hii kazi yenye nataka kuendelea. Anapata tayari kuna pesa yenye iko hapo hivyo kwa system. Na sasa ndio ulipwe, lazima uende utafute mtu kama Osoro ama wenye wako kwa roads committee pale kwa parliament, uwapee kama 20%. Sasa hii ni pesa yako itabidi utafute from nowhere ndio ulipwe sasa pending bill. Uende utafute kama ni 20%. Ah, my MP wote hawananga pesa. Hawa jamaa wanakuanga wamesota mbaya. The only thing they have ni ile wako na ile kitu inaitwa social capital. So wanakuja kwa site. Jamaa anaangalia nani ako na pending bill, nani ajalipo hapa, nani ajalipo hapa. Then wanatafuta njia ya kuingia pale kwa ministry ya kublock asilipwe. Alafu sasa lazima uwatafute. Ukisha watafuta, uwapee kama 20%. Uwapee kama 10%. Sasa tuseme kama ulikuwa na project ya 20 million, unapeana kama 2 million. Hawa jamaa wakisha yeka wana pocket hiyo pesa, wakisha pocket. Nani waheshimiwa MPs? Wana pocket hiyo pesa, alafu hautalipwa saa hiyo. Siku hilo utakuja kulipwa hiyo pending bill, kama hata itachukua hata kama ni 2 months, watakata tena another 20%, ndio pesa ingie kwa mfuko yako bwana. It is very wrong to be a contractor in this country. If you want to die haraka, jaribu kufungua kampuni saa hii na ukue genuine. Utakufa. Hii Kenya ni ya wakora. And the only what wana survive ni wakora.
Thank you very much. Thank you, engineer. Umetupatia very valuable contributions to this. Thank you so much. I would like to recognize the people who have been on speaker panel for a long time. Wameinua mikono. So nawapa orodha ya watu watazungumza next. Please respect the order. So we have Western. By the Western, Daniel. After Daniel, itakuwa reject. And then on Sando, 6,000 and Vivian. In that order.
Thank you so much for the opportunity. Morning, fellow compatriots and Africans and people of the world. Listening to the speaker who just concluded, yeah, it is a somber picture of Kenya, but that's what it is. It is the road that we have to clean. And we are committed to doing just that. But one thing I wish to alert you to is that in any revolution, there are counter-revolutionaries, there are reactionaries. It would be incredible to have a mass movement of this nature and have everybody else reading from the same script. And we're also fighting against the weight of history in Kenya. a history defined by sycophancy, by betrayal, by retrogressive politics. And therefore, we are not going to overcome those challenges overnight, such that the language we use, our choice of words must reflect the discipline that we are calling out the government officials and William Ruto in particular for lacking. It takes me back to, you know, the conversation by the previous speaker, you know, who is illegal in Kenya, who is legal, who is a Somali, who is a Tanzanian, who is not. Those kind of calibrations are not consistent with the revolution. A revolution is defined by solidarity. It's defined by camaraderie. You know, we are united by one cause: social justice, economic emancipation, freedom, constitutionalism, and a better life for all and sundry. When Kenya works for Kenyans, it will work for Somalis who are in Kenya. It will work for Tanzanians who are in Kenya. It will work for everybody who is in Kenya. But the political elite preside over the rot that we've been talking about ad nauseum and will continue talking about. And then when we raise issues, they start finger pointing. It is that person, it is this person, it's that tribe. We dare not fall prey to that retrogressive politics. Choices of words such as watuameno and what, let's not go there. This character Murkomen is wanting, as far as ethics are concerned, is engaged in untoward behavior, corruption. Now, we focus on that. There's a lot to call him out for. Let's not get onto phenotypical aspects, because that's genocidal. That's what genociders do. They identify you based on your phenotype, the shape of your head, shape of your nose, even your walking style. Let's not get there. It's discipline that must define us. Well, I've got a Kenyan ID, you've got a Kenyan ID. But when you go to the streets, your government is shooting at you using live ammunition. So how better are you compared to, say, a Somalia or a South Sudanese and what have you? How better are you? Secondly, let us not draw from the curse of Berlin. The curse of Berlin, 1884, 1885. You know, cartographers just divided Africa. This is Tanzania, this is Kenya. No. Let's not do that. No African is a foreigner in Africa. Well, you go to Europe, you're a foreigner. You go to the US, or you're a foreigner. Oh, you in Africa, you're also a foreigner? How ridiculous can that be? So let's guard against any language, any behavior that is going to undermine our revolution. The Kenyan government, beginning with the previous regimes, have always waged war against ideas. They have been scared of ideas to death. You know, this war against intellectualism didn't start yesterday. It's been there. Because when you reduce people to identities, when you divert people from ideas, transformative ideas, you know, from, you know, caucusing and canvassing and you know, getting together on the basis of cross-cutting socio-economic and political ends, the government becomes vulnerable. So let's not go there. The politics of who is who and who is who, let's not go there. There's no illegal person in Kenya. All people are in Kenya as human beings, they deserve dignity. And that's why we're insisting that the institutions of governance work. Secondly, it's against amnesia. I think it was Anne raised a very valid point against amnesia. Amnesia, this propensity to forget quite easily. Our discourse tends to be sometimes narrow, whereby if I find William Ruto's government reprehensible, now I have to look back in history and find out what was good about some other regime there. No, you don't have to have binaries that you like this, you dislike that. You like William Ruto's government, you dislike Raila Odinga's advice. No, we're saying this is a continuum. Post-colonial successive governments in Kenya are part of a continuum. One and the same thing. They have presided over rot. They have lorded over Kenyans. They have presided over poverty, extrajudicial executions. They have turned the exchequer into sources of petty cash. And so the entire establishment is rotten. So let us not be amnesic. Let us not have short memories. Let us not have these meaningless calibrations. Kibaki, for instance, was not the best president, but he's the best president when you look at development from a brick and mortar perspective. That somebody builds a road, builds a railway line, builds some skyscraper, but disregards human dignity. Development, ladies and gentlemen, fellow compatriots, it's about freedom. It's about freedom. A society is developed to the extent that the citizens of that society have choice. You've got choice. You can make choices as far as your life is concerned. You've got options. You are not developed to the extent that people have no choices. You are not developed to the extent that people cannot even meet their basic needs. So what is the use of an elevated freeway when people can't take their kids to school? When people can't afford medicine? When there's no food security? So when you calibrate these people, you can only successfully do so when you focus on very artificial, meaningless things. But when you center people, their dignity, their livelihoods, all these people were spectacular disasters. And they've been feeding into one another. Third, law, legalese. Yeah, it's good that lawyers help us. What does this constitution say? What does this article say? What is in this bill? It's good, the law. But do you know that the more laws a country is, the more ill-governed it is? Do you know that? The more bills a country is, the more chaotic that country is. Do you know that? Do you know that where in a country where people are fascinated and fixated on the constitution and what it says, that is the citadel, the symbol of impunity and lawlessness? And our political elite know that. Britain doesn't have a written law. Is there chaos in that country? It does not have a written constitution. Is there chaos in that country? The US constitution is something small like this, between 17 and 20 pages, and it's been around for years. Do you find chaos in that country? But our political elite think that the problem is not them, the problem is the law. Oh, I'm going to sign another bill. No, 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 no. The law, the constitution is only but a framework. What gives life to the constitution, what gives life to the law, is a value system. Norms, the norms that undergird public life as well as private life. Discipline, social justice, patriotism. Those are things that can't be defined in the law, but they undergird people's behavior, both in public life and in private. And the political elite must lead by example as far as that is concerned. But here, they know, oh no, the problem is that policy. The problem is that's why we have 1,001 parastatals, you know, ostensibly taking care of the road infrastructure. But as the previous speakers shown, and we know, these are conduits for corruption. Nothing else but corruption and decadence. Yeah. Why would you have 1,001 parastatals all in the name of, you know, infrastructure road? Why can't one just be enough? Yeah, you must expand the trough and create eating opportunities for your cronies, for your friends, and as he puts it, your concubines and what have you. That is the sleaze that we are fighting against. And it's not a legal thing. It's not a constitutional thing. It's not this rigid interpretation of the law that's going to get us out of this morass. It is the insistence that we will demand nothing short of ethics, nothing short of values in public life. In other countries, why would a minister of transport, for instance, resign when people die en masse on road? Why? He wasn't driving the bus. Was he was not driving the train, but they resign. They fall on their sword. Political responsibility. I've fallen short of the expectations of my people. But in Kenya, somebody will take you to the constitution. No, look what Ruto was saying. No, these people have not exhausted what were their legal options. So I can't do anything against them. Okay, when evidence is provided, you realize you are not looking for evidence. You are not. Or, you know, you have destroyed the evidence. That's why you're asking people for evidence. You know, it's not there. Or, you know, you have compromised the judiciary. So you're asking for evidence. You know, come on, let's not fall prey. This is Orwellian speak, where pigs in animal farm consistently question the capacity and ability of the rest of the animals to remember things. That's what they are doing to us, that we can't remember things, that we don't understand the subtleties of their shenanigans against us. No, they're insulting our intelligence. William Ruto can sign 1,001 bills, but those will not be the cure to our social, economic, and political malaise. Our challenges are political, they're moral, they're ethical, and they're discipline related. They are ideational, and that's what this revolution is about, ideas, a different kind of thinking from this backward thinking that has held us back over this decade. Gen Z, I hear sometimes, you know, somebody gets a mic and says, I was not there. No, you need not have been there. Read. You can talk about things that happened decades ago. You are not there. And you will talk about them authoritatively. Read. They're trying to take advantage of the fact that you are not there. Okay. So when they tell you, you sit down, young man or young woman, you are not there when these things were happening. Okay. Do you only have an authority to talk about things that you witnessed firsthand? Do you only have an authority to talk about things, you know, you have seen happen, or talk about countries that you have visited? You talk about things that happened long before you were born, and you can do it authoritatively because there are books, there's history. We inform ourselves. So the moment you start by making this disclaimer that I was not there, then okay, what does that even mean? Does it mean if somebody is senior to you, they're more knowledgeable than you are? You see how ridiculous that is? Does it mean that you have stayed in government for years, you have more knowledge or more experience, but your experience is useless? You've been in government for decades, but your experience is useless. You've only succeeded in stealing money and impoverishing people. I was born the other day. I'm only, you know, 20, 30, whatever years, but I'm committed to transforming this country. So why do you pour scorn on my capacity? No, ladies and gentlemen, fellow compatriots, let's be careful about what these people are saying and what they're trying to do. So I think I would encourage you, we continue pushing. We are pushing against an establishment. We are pushing against an establishment. Some people say, no, the parliament can be redeemed. No, we can impeach William Ruto. No, you can't. You can't redeem this establishment. You can't cherry pick. This is a rotten wall, and you have to uproot the entire thing. That's what a revolution is. It brings forth a new transformation, a new dispensation, a new way of doing things and thinking. It's not a game of musical chairs. You go to your room and then you take a table, you put it there, you take a chair, put it there, and say, now this room is different. I'm in a new house. You're not in a new house. You've just rearranged your furniture. You are not in a different house. So let us not be, you know, fixated and blown away by cabinet reshuffles, signing of bills. I don't know, doing that. And that's a game of musical chairs. Mo used to do that. Kibaki did it. Uhuru Kenyatta did it. But we are here where we are. We're here where we are. We're not moving. Why? Because the architecture is decayed. Must get rid of it and get new people on board, new ideas on board, new thinking on board. Ladies and gentlemen, wish you well. Thank you so much for the opportunity.
Wow. Afro, I want to yield my mic after Western has spoken and was it necessary fool the engineer? I have nothing to add. Guys, this is a strong movement. We keep pushing. Ruto must go. By the way, kuna watu wanaongea story ya 2027. Watakuja hapa. Ruto is going now. Ruto must go now. Hakuna cha 2027. We are not waiting. Let me step down so that you can admit other people. Niko na DMs mingi sana. Wacha watu waingie.
Thank you so much, Chege. Thank you so much, Western. Powerful, powerful submission, man. I'm still processing everything that you have said. I mean, well comprehensive. The system has to be brought down. The rot is in the system. Thank you so much for your powerful 3 points. Who was next on cue? I think I'm good at giving a line.
Daniel, next.
Morning, guys. Kwanza nitaongea kwa Kiswahili. Na tangu ya Kiswahili. Watu wameongea vizuri sana, point zao zimetolewa vile inafaa. Na wanasiasa wamekuja na ile lengo lao kwanza kwa kugawanya kisiasa. Na hiyo ndio chanzo cha shida yetu, tatizo letu. Hizi vitengo zenye tumeziona hapa, kila mtu ameongelea, kuna wenye wameongelea, Kenha, kuna wenye wameongelea, hizi hata SRC, hizi vitengo zote za kiserikali. Hata kuna ingine hapa inajiitwa sijui Kenya sijui Union of Clinical Officers. These are organizations zimewekwa kwa hapo ili kunyanyasa ule mtu wa chini ambaye wanafaa watetee huko juu. Na hii revolution